Hey guys, what's up? Eric Merced here, and today I want to do a long overdue review of an application that I use a lot when I use my Windows PC, and that program is called Tablet Pro, and you're going to see it loaded up here on the left-hand corner of the screen. But before I get into what this program is used for, I want to get into some of the problems that tablet users on Windows PCs like the Surface Pro or this Lenovo tablet have that this program pretty much solves. So let me just turn the program off. So I have Affinity Photo loaded up, which is a program that I'm using a lot to draw on my Windows computer. Now, I have the Windows set up in tablet mode, but the problem with this is that even in tablet mode, Affinity Photo is not really optimized for tablet mode in Windows as it is maybe in iOS, right? So one of the problems that I have or that I face when I'm drawing in Affinity Photo is sometimes I want to draw without any distractions on the side. So I don't want to have my brushes or layers on the side, and I don't want to have my tools palettes on the side. So in order for me to get rid of everything, I have to go to the view menu with the pen and hit toggle UI to get rid of everything. And then I can pretty much draw distraction free, just have the whole screen to play with. Now, when I want to bring back the screen, I would have to go back into view and toggle UI to bring everything back. For example, if I wanted to select the eraser tool or the lasso tool, and I would do what I have to do. And then if I want distraction free, I would go back into view and toggle UI. That's just one of the problems. There's too much clicking, and I feel that clicking or that tapping to get to do one thing is just too much of a distraction when you're in the flow of drawing. Another thing that is wrong with, or another problem with Affinity Photo is that unlike the iOS version, you can't rotate the screen with touch, right? So in order to rotate the screen, again, you have to go to view and you have to either hit rotate left, rotate right, or reset rotation when you're done. So if I want to rotate this to the right, I have to, again, go to view, hit rotate right. And if I want it rotated more, I have to hit it again. And if I want it rotated a little bit more, I have to hit rotate right again. So you can see how this can be very distracting to your workflow. And if I want to reset my view, I just go to reset rotation. Now, where Tablet Pro comes in is that it solves all these problems for you. So I'm going to go ahead and call up Tablet Pro, right, and have it come up on the side. And what Tablet Pro basically allows you to do is to set your custom keys as you would have them on the keyboard. It allows you to set your custom keys so you can get to them quicker, right? So it is optimized for tablets, window tablets like the Surface Pro or this Lenovo tablet, to help you get things done much quicker. And you can customize this per program. So right now I have it customized to Affinity Photo, and you can have it customized to Photoshop, Clip Studio, Paint, Leonardo app, or any other app that you use, that you can basically assign. You're basically, what you're doing is assigning shortcut keys found in the app into the Tablet Pro application. So for example, the first thing we spoke about is getting a full screen view. Basically, I have a button up here that once I press that button, it instantly gets me into full screen view. If I tap it again, see, just one tap gets me into full screen, one tap gets me out of full screen real easily. Another button I have is the save button. So when we're working, obviously we know that it's important to save often. I have an assign button up here, which I have colored because it's a very important button. I have that assigned to basically, once I tap that, the document will save. If it's not saved, if it's the first time saving, it's going to ask you to save as, then you'll name it, you'll pick a location for it and save it. But from there on, when you're working on the document, once you hit save, it's the same thing as hitting Control S on the Windows PC. Another button I have is the undo button. So if I take a brush here and I do a couple of marks here and I want to undo, basically I just tap once, two, three to undo three times or as many times as I want. Or I have another button next to that to redo whatever it is that I put down, right? It makes the process pretty simple. It is very, very, it's a very awesome app, and I really highly recommend it for anyone who works on a Windows PC and wants to have these custom buttons to work with on screen. Moving on, another one button I have is the brush button. So if I am in a different tool, like the fill tool, the bucket tool, I can just hit the B button and it'll get me into my brushes, back into my brushes. Next to that, I have the eraser button, right? Go back to the brush and go back to the eraser. And let's undo that, let's undo that, let's undo that, and let's undo that. You can see it's pretty quick in the way it works. Another button I have is below that is the button to make the brush tip of the brush size bigger or smaller. So for example, if I start hitting the increase size button here, you can see the brush getting bigger. If I start hitting the decrease size, the brush starts getting smaller. Real simple. I don't have to go into the menus and I don't have to have a keyboard, which I believe if you're working on a tablet like this and you have to have a keyboard next to you, it kind of defeats the purpose of working on these tablets, and in my opinion. See, I showed you guys how much of a pain it is to rotate the screen, and right now I don't even have the screen. There we go, reset rotation there. So I showed you guys in Affinity Photo how difficult or how much of a pain it is to pretty much rotate your screen since you can't do it with touch. So I assigned three buttons here on the Tablet Pro toolbar to basically help me rotate my screen. I assigned one to rotate left, rotate right, or reset rotation. So as I'm drawing, if I want to rotate, I just have to keep pressing the button. And I can keep rotating whichever way I want. Hit one button there by mistake, or reset rotation. All right, and one of the other ones that I want to talk about, one of the last ones I want to talk about is lasso tool. Well, I have the lasso tool here, right, just to make quick selections, but I also have a deselect when I don't need the lasso tool anymore. And again, you can assign these buttons to the shortcut keys that you mostly use. And it'll make your workflow better. I highly recommend Tablet Pro for anyone that has a Windows PC. It's very inexpensive, and apart from the fact that it's very inexpensive, it's really a really valuable tool. I'm gonna leave a link to their website on the descriptions below this YouTube video, so you guys can go ahead and give them a try. And support the developers, right? They're constantly working on making it better. So that's it for this video. Hope you guys liked this quick review and demonstration of Tablet Pro. Until then, guys, thanks for watching. God bless you guys. Peace.